In 1973, the U.S. Supreme Court effectively legalized abortion in America in a landmark case referred to as Roe v. Wade. This case sparked a debate in the United States that continues up until today. Today, abortion is legal in many parts of the world, as well as practiced covertly in parts of the world where it isn't legal. The argument comes down to this: when does life begin? If life begins at conception, well, then abortion is murder, plain and simple. If life begins at birth, the viability of the fetus, or any other benchmark, then abortion is simply a medical procedure that a woman should have the right to perform if she so chooses. There is a great deal of debate over the science and the politics of this issue, but that should not concern us as Bible students. What we want to know is whether or not the scriptures give any information on this topic. Does the Bible tell us when life begins? The answer is a resounding yes. The Bible is explicit and clear. A child in the womb is a person, distinct and separate from the mother. Let's look at a few examples. Samson, the judge of Israel, said, "For I have been a Nazarite to God from my mother's womb." Judges 16:17. King David said, "For you formed my inward parts, you knitted me together in my mother's womb." Psalm 139, verse 13. Another compelling example is the case of John the Baptist. While he was still in his mother's womb, the child leapt for joy. When Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the baby leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Luke 1:41. Elizabeth would describe the baby's reaction as, "The baby in my womb leapt for joy," implying that John felt emotions that were unique and separate from his mother. Or when Rebecca was pregnant with twin boys, they are referred to as distinct people, the future patriarchs of two great nations. And the Lord said to her, "Two nations are in your womb, and two peoples from within you shall be divided. The one shall be stronger than the other, the older shall serve the younger." Genesis 25:23. In each and every case, the scriptures describe unborn children as being distinct beings apart from their mother. They are reliant upon the mother's womb for growth, but the baby should not be confused with the womb of the mother in the same way that we don't confuse a hospital patient with the life support system they are connected to. These babies have their own personalities, emotions, bodies, identity, and God remarks on the unique purpose He has for each and every one of them. If this were not enough, well, Solomon, he settles the issue in the book of Ecclesiastes. "As you do not know the way the spirit comes to the bones in the womb of a woman with child, so you do not know the work of God who makes everything." Ecclesiastes 11, verse 5. It is in the womb that the spirit of a child comes into it. Abortion is the ending of a discrete and individual human life that was made in the image of God. When we purposefully end a human life, that is called murder, and it is evil. The age, gender, size, or circumstances surrounding the pregnancy don't change that. The moment that a man and a woman engage in sexual activity, there is the potential that a child will be conceived. This is exactly why God warns that sexual activity is only intended for marriage. "Therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Genesis 2:24. Though abstinence until marriage is hard and culturally unpopular, it is the Bible's answer to the question of unwanted pregnancies. "For this is the will of God, your sanctification, that you abstain from sexual immorality, that each one of you know how to control his own body in holiness and honor." 1 Thessalonians 4, 3-4. All children deserve love and life from the womb and beyond.